the Name of the Day Vapes YouTube channel. I'm Chops.
I'm Ryan.
I'm Jason.
And we are your juice council. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to take our juice line that we personally carry here at Everyday Vapes, and we're going to judge it. Judge it hard as we possibly can, only because, not just for us, but for you guys too, because you got to know what's good and know what's really going on in the market. So first up, we're going to try Monster Melon from Cuttwood again. Now, a lot of you guys have probably heard of Cuttwood out there. It's a very premium juice. Guys, have you heard of Cuttwood before we even start carrying it in store?
I've heard a lot about Cuttwood.
Yeah, that's been my, people come in, we've had it, people come in the store and ask for it before,
One of the most social media induced flavors and line juices I've ever seen.
And straight out of California, if you know one thing about California, they are big about their e-juice because basically vaping, it's coming from the West, basically. I mean, we here in North Carolina, we're just now getting into it. But California, they've been hopping on it really big time now. So we got our separate mods here, and we're individually just going to drip this. And we're kind of going to give you, well, we're not going to look towards our personal opinion on this juice because we're going to really just get down to the details of what it really tastes like. Does it really taste good? Not just to our personal opinions, but just to a non-biased, just all-around opinion. Now, some of us may not be into melons, but we're going to think of it like, what if somebody was into melons? Would it be something for them?
Now, first up, we got moss melons gripped on a Plumville RDA carry here.
Now, I must say, it's not too bad. Now, this has mango, papaya, and cantaloupe in it. Now, of all the flavors that are in there, what are you really tasting the most?
Taste the papaya, honestly, and the cantaloupe.
I've never had papaya before.
I've had papaya, and it tastes it's remarkably similar.
It's not too bad. Now, if you look at your vape while you're vaping it, it actually makes it taste a little more... Yes. A little more mango-y.
Yes.
The mango is definitely the biggest hitter. This is the mango.
You get it right when... On the intake, it's immediate.
It is.
Absolutely. Now, I'm not a big mango fan. I'm more of like a watermelon fan myself. Yeah. And when it comes to mango and cantaloupe, it's more of a, not really a sweet, fruity flavor. It's more of that robust, like, pow, just fruit right into your face.
Very tart.
Tart. That is a perfect word for this. Tart.
Very, a little bit tangy.
Yes.
It's a little tangy.
But it's nothing special. Honestly, to me at least, I'm not a huge fan of fruit flavors, and to me, a fruit flavor has to really hit home with me personally, and for this, it just doesn't hit the spot completely. It's a bit too everywhere. It's lacking a direction.
That's true.
It's lacking a direction in where it's trying to go.
I couldn't tell you exactly what melon, if you didn't tell me what melons were in it, I wouldn't be able to.
I would say it's just fruit. It tastes like fruit.
I want more of a sweetness out of it, but a lot of people, they like fruit, but they don't like the complete sweetness that they get out of it. So you're not really looking for a Jolly Rancher fruit flavor out there. Definitely Monster Melon is going to be your bet. Now next up, we got Unicorn's Milk. Now this guy has been huge in the market, right? Now everybody's been talking about this because way back in the past, they had a little trouble with a little chemical that they had called, what was it, titanium dioxide. And that was just to basically dye the juice inside of it. Now, of course, as you can see, it doesn't look pink like it used to in the past, so there's zero titanium dioxide, and it's still a fantastic flavor that it used to have way back in the past. Now, essentially, it should taste like strawberry Nesquik. Now, when I say strawberry Nesquik, I mean like straight up, you get the strawberries and you get the milk. One of the biggest points of this juice that people point out is that it has this milky flavor to it. And some people love it, and some people don't. So we're going to try it out ourselves. Now, we've probably tried this juice out a million times.
Oh, yeah.
But we're going to try it out in a non-boiled.
Yeah, very unbiased.
As much as we can.
We'll say
I'm still not a big fan of it.
On the intake, it hits you with the sweetness first. The sweetness is definitely the first thing to hit.
It's the milk. You know, I loved it in the past, and I still love it now. It's just a great vape, and it's definitely an all-day vape for myself.
Oh, yeah. But the now they're with being one of, to me, this is one of my favorite juices. It's one of the favorites that has really hit home with everything that I go for with juice. But the one thing I have noticed, when you do use this juice for a long time, the flavor does get very dull.
Start getting vapor tone, huh?
Yeah. You get vapor tone very quick with this because it's such a distinct flavor. It's such a very just on target. It's supposed to be one thing. And so when you start focusing on that, when you start focusing on that more, get vapor tongue after a while, it starts to dull itself.
It's one of those juices that you just want to lay right beside your bed and just have a nice relaxing time. As soon as you get home, that's the juice to carry. It's got the fruit, it's got the custardy taste, it's all there on point. It's definitely one of the number one sellers.
Oh, yeah.
Next up, we got Sugar Bear, which is probably their second best seller right now. Now, Cuttwood also has one that's called, what's the new juice?
Boss's Reserve.
Boss's Reserve. We don't have that yet, but as soon as we get it coming in, we definitely will be in doing it.
Oh, I cannot wait.
It sounds like it's supposed to be big.
It sounds phenomenal.
Yeah. But back to Sugar Bear here. Sugar Bear is definitely, have you ever tasted 10 grams? Of course you have. Teddy Grahams is just one of those all-time childhood snacks that everybody loved. We still love it as adults. You just can't get it as often because it's not adulty. But if you can't get it as an adult, don't feel bad about getting Sugar Bear because it's on this point. At least for me. And as you can tell, I've vaped on this before many, many times. Sugar Bear was sent to me months before I even had Cuttwood in the store. And ever since then, I have been hooked on this stuff. So you're not really going to get a non-biased point of view out of me because I love the Sugar Bear. So it all comes down to these guys.
I'll tell you if it's good. Don't worry.
That's right.
I got it.
Okay, now the cinnamon hits you immediately. The cinnamon is very prominent.
Don't think Cinnabon, think cinnamon. Think you're biting into, like, freshly baked Cinnabon.
So I will say, it's very weird how they pulled this off, because the cinnamon taste kind of hits you, it's kind of like a ball, if that makes sense. As your tongue is going over the vapor, it kind of hits you, like, in little snippets. I don't know if anyone else gets this feel, but that's how I get with cinnamon. Cinnamon is very prickly. It's a very prickly
It's not
flavor.
For me.
Does that make sense?
I think it's really
that makes
smooth.
Sense. That makes
prickly is gonna... It's very smooth for me. Very smooth cinnamon.
Sugar Bear has never been smooth for me.
Jason feels juice like none
That's
other man.
That's so
But of course, my point of view, it's fantastic. The stuff is just great.
I agree with Chops totally.
It's sweet, it's fantastic, and I'm shocked it doesn't sell as much as it does, really. Everybody's all about the unicorn's milk, and now Monster Melon's starting to make a debut, but Sugar Bear is still right up there fighting for number one spot.
Sugar Bear, I love it, but I can't do it all day. It's the prickly thing, man. It's with the cinnamon. It's with the cinnamon. I don't know what's up with my tongue. It's cinnamon.
I've had people come in and bought a second bottle of it because it was that good. Mm-hmm. People have come back for just for Sugar Bear.
Well, gentlemen, it's brought us down to this time. Cuttwood, is it worth the price that it is? Now, Cuttwood, depending on where you get it from, can go from $11.99 to $14.99. All depends on where you get it from. But for me, if I was a consumer, $11.99 sounds fairly good.
$11.99 is a steal, honestly.
Absolutely.
It's a very...
It's 20 milliliter, right?
Or 15 milliliters.
So. Mm-hmm. 15.
It's the best you can get, best bang for your buck. It's the grade A, high quality juice.
It even comes in 3 milligrams, too. A lot of people are going from 3 to 6, and they're not digging the 6. Cuttwood has finally come out with a 3, just for you.
We just started carrying 30 bottles, 30 milliliter bottles of unicorn's milk. So
Unicorn's milk and
get a 30 milliliter bottle, we have those, too.
Who's the winner? Who's the winner?
Yeah, hold up. We do have to choose a winner here.
Winner?
What is the all-time best Cuttwood altogether?
Out of the three that we
have? Out of the three right here.
Well, my vote is on Sugar Bear.
I have to go with Unicorn's Milk.
I'm going to have to go with Unicorn's Milk as well. 2v1. It looks like Monster Melon is not getting any love. But hey, it doesn't mean you might not like it, though.
Short. For the fruit lovers out there, you'll enjoy it a lot.
Yeah, you got sweet, sweet, and tarty, so you can't go wrong.
Have it, boys.
Well, until next time, I'm Chops.
Ryan.
Jason.
Here from Everyday Vapes. Y'all have a good one.